10th plus 2 level over andum thodarndhu maanila alavil pala sadhanaigalai purindhu varum Namakkal Kurinji Kalvi Nirvanangalil CBSE paadathittathil senior secondary palliyaga tharam uyarthappattu IIT NEET thervugalukku pala vetriyalargalai uruvaakkiya aasiriyargalai mulu nera aasiriyargalaga paniyamarthappattu thinamdorum vaguppugal nadaiperum
Kurinji Educational Institution Kavettipatti Namakkal Admission in progress CBSE KG to 12 contact 9025895176 Metric 6 to 12 contact 9344567484 For online admission log on to www.kurinjischoolnkl.in
அனைவருக்கும் காலை வணக்கம் நாமக்கல் குறிஞ்சி கல்வி நிறுவனங்களின் தாளாளர் என் தேவியண்ணன் பேசுகின்றேன் மெட்ரிக் மற்றும் ஸ்டேட் போர்டு பாடத்திட்டங்களில் பயின்று 10ஆம் வகுப்பு தேர்ச்சி பெற்று 11ஆம் வகுப்பில் சேர இருக்கின்ற அனைத்து மாணவ மாணவிகளுக்கும் பாடங்கள் அனைத்தும் வீடியோ எடுக்கப்பட்டு யூடியூப் மூலம் கற்பிக்கப்படுகிறது எனவே மாணவர்கள் அனைவரும் உற்று நோக்கி பயன்பெறுமாறு அன்போடு கேட்டுக்கொள்கின்றேன் நன்றி வணக்கம்
மார்னிங் டு எவ்ரி ஒன் நவ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு லேர்ன் அபவுட் ஃபிசிக்ஸ் அப் டு 10th ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் லெவல் யூ ஸ்டடிடு வெரி வெல் அபவுட் தி சப்ஜெக்ட் ஆஃப் சயின்ஸ் இன் திஸ் சயின்ஸ் தே ஆர் கிளாசிஃபைட் இன் டு 4 கேட்டகரிஸ் யூ நோ வெரி வெல் தே ஆர் கால்ட் ஆஸ் Physics, Chemistry, Botany and Zoology. Among these four subjects, physics is the very important role to play in our day-to-day life. Why we are calling very important role in the day-to-day life means without physics we cannot live in the world. Of course, we are going to prove one by one with the experimental verification. So in the 11th physics syllabus, we are going to learn about many of the subdivisions in the field of physics. For example, measurement, mechanics, and the laws of motion and the rotational motion like that. Initially, the physics are majorly classified into classical physics as well as the modern physics. In the classical physics, they are specified They are simplified like kinematics and kinetics. And in modern physics, they are simplified like atomic physics and nuclear physics as well as the molecular physics. In our future classes, we are going to learn about one by one very deeply in our situation. Now we are going to learn The plus one physics syllabus, the lesson number one, it is named as Nature of Physical World and the Measurement. So initially the lesson number one is classified into two subparts. Among these two subparts, now we are going to learn the first subpart is Nature of Physical World. We will see very deeply in this class. See in the board, the name of the lesson is A nature of physical world. Initially, the question comes like, what is mean by science? I'm already told in the introduction part, the science is the very major role in our day-to-day life. So in that science, it is derived from the Latin word, it is named as scientia. From this Latin word scientia only, the science is derived. The meaning of science is nothing but to know. From this word itself, we can get the meaning of science. How it means? What is the meaning of to know? To know means the unknown values we able to modify to known value. The unknown is the sense. We not able to get anything from anywhere while during the process of experimental during the process of practical we able to get the meaning of these things so we conclude that from the Latin word scientia only the science is derived the meaning of science is to know everything not only here not only there whatever it may be we able to get the meaning for all those things by using the subject of science So while discuss about the science subject means we able to get the meaning for everything. In Tamil we have to call Ariviyal. What is the word? Ariviyal. In Tamil we are calling as Ariviyal. Ariviyal is nothing but knowing the truth. What is the meaning of truth? We know very well. So what are the things are going to be? Tell as much as possible. Tell proved by ourselves. We can get everything by during the process of science. From the Latin word, it is called as science. In Tamil, we have to call Ariviyal. So Ariviyal is nothing but knowing the truth values. So we define the science. What is science here? Science is nothing but science is the systematic organization of knowledge gained through observation, experimentation, and logical learning. What are these three things? See here, it is the systematic organization. Whatever it may be, wherever we go, we have to do step by step process. Why means what is the process we can continue? We have to follow some of the rules and regulations. We have to follow some of the rules and regulations. That is nothing but systematic organization. So as well as we can call science is also known as the systematic organization of knowledge gained. Where we able to get it the knowledge? During the process of observation, during the process of experimentation, during the process of logical learning. What are these three things means? These three things are called as we have to do the experimental, we have to do the observation, we have to do the logical learning. Observation means suppose they are performing any of the practical purpose, that practical purpose we have to observe very keep. So the keen observation leads here we can get the knowledge. So science is the systematic organization of knowledge gained through observation. Through this observation we are able to get the knowledge. And next we have to move experimentation. Already we are heard about many of the names. For example, the verification of resistance by using Ohm's law. What are going to do in that process means, according to the Coulomb law, according to the Ohm's law, according to the Newton law, what are the laws we have to follow? From that laws we are able to gain some of the knowledge. And as well as the logical learning, while discuss about the concept of the science, in that science we can get our knowledge from many of the places. So what are the things we have to do means the science is the systematic organization of knowledge gained through observation, experimentation and logical learning. Not only these three things, among these three things it is plays very important role. And next we have to move. Majorly the science is classified into two types. What are the two types? First we have to call physical science and next is the biological science. Up to 10th standard level you studied the subject of science. In that subject science they are classified four categories. What are they? Physics, chemistry, botany and zoology. So physics and chemistry are called as the physical science and botany and zoology are the biological science. In that physical science, what are the things we are going to be studied? What are the things going to be studying? That means which are the things are called as non-living things we have to under this category. We have to maintain under this category. Which one? Physical science. And biological science means living things. So we conclude that the concept physical science is dealt with the non-living things and biological science deals with the living things. So initially the science is majorly classified into two types only. They are named as physical science and the biological science. In physical science we are going to discuss about the non-living things, and biological science means we are going to be discuss living things. What is that? We are going to be discuss living things. So non-living things or living things, whatever it may be, we are able to study under the categories of science. Okay, in that science we have to follow some of the method that is named as scientific method. What is that? Scientific method. In scientific method, it is a step by step approach in studying natural phenomena and establishing laws. What is this? So I am already told we have to follow some of the rules and regulations. They will ask, what are the rules to be followed while performing an experiment? What are the rules to be followed while performing an practical knowledge? So such type of questions arise here. So scientific method means it is a step by step approach in studying natural phenomena as well as establishing laws. I am already told such of the laws like Newton's law, Coulomb law, as well as the Ohm's law. And then we can call in the concept of the heat, Joule's law also. So these are established by performing the experimental arrangement. By performing the experimental arrangement only, we are able to establishing such type of laws. And scientific method means, I am already told, it is a step by step approach. In this step by step approach, we have to follow some of the rules. We have to follow some of the features. What are these? See here, these are all the general features about the scientific method. What are the general features? First one, systematic observation. Suppose while performing an experiment, we have to follow some of the rules and regulation. So that's why we have to write systematic observation. Whatever it may be, we have to follow. And the second one is controlled experimentation. What is that? Controlled experimentation. Controlled experimentation means, suppose for example, I think you are studied in the 10th standard level nuclear fission and fusion process. Nuclear fission process means what will happen? The heavier nucleus is bombarded with the neutron, it is splitting into two lighter fragments. In that nuclear fusion process, suppose a neutron is bombarded with the heavier nucleus, means it is splitting into two lighter fragments. In that case, the neutron acts as an important role. That is called the controlled experimentation. Why I am telling the example here means, in that case, the two categories are present. We know that. What are they means? The explosion of the atom bomb and the hydrogen bomb and the power production in the nuclear reactor. For example, while considering the nuclear reactor means it is a controlled manner. While exploiting atom bomb means it is the uncontrolled manner. So whatever we do, we have to keep in mind, controlled experimentation. And third is the qualitative and the quantitative reasoning. What is this? Qualitative means it is called as a number. Qualitative means it is able to get the actual output of the given specimen. Quantitative means we have to call as a number. So suppose we are going to purchase anything from our market, means it should be in both the conditions. What is that? Qualitative as well as the quantitative. We have to get more number, but all the items must be in quality condition. So like that. and fourth is the mathematical modeling. This is the important role in our science concept. So without mathematics also we cannot live in the world, of course. So in the mathematics it plays very important role in our science subject. So we have to follow mathematical modeling also. And last one is the prediction and verification of theories. What is that? Prediction and verification of theories. Prediction is nothing but, so suppose we are doing any of the experiment, means we can get some of the output. The output is better or not, we have to check it. As well as verification of theories. Suppose we have to follow some of the rules and regulation, means that rules and regulations are able to continue or not, we have to check it. For example, suppose while considering the example, means see here, in the general futures, suppose we are considering any of the examples. Let us consider a metallic rod. What we have to call? Let us consider a metallic rod. In that metallic rod, we are going to be heating. Suppose the metallic rod is going to be heating. That metallic rod is heated means the metallic rod having the two ends. One end of the metallic rod is heated. What will happen in the another end? The another end also heating, because while applying the heat to one end, means it is able to transfer to the another end also. So in this situation, some of the questions we are arising, they are: what happens within the rod when it is heated? While heating, what happens within the rod? They will ask. We have to answer it. And how does the heat reach the other end? What is that? How does the heat reach the other end? I am already told, suppose we are heating at one end, means the heat is transferred to the another end. They will ask how. And third is the, is this effect true for all materials? Like this they will ask. What is that? Is this effect is true for all materials? Such type of questions are arising here. And if heat flows through the material, is it possible to visualize heat? Only we are able to analyze it, not able to visualize. So such type of questions they will ask. So in that categories we have to follow such type of rules and regulations. So up to this we are discuss about the science subject. In that science subject, now we are going to enter very important role. It is named as physics. So in physics, where the places the physics is derived? Look here. Physics is derived from the Greek word physis. What is that? Physis. So up to this category we able to learn. So now itself we able to recognize the physics is derived from the Greek word physis. From the Greek word physis only the physics is derived. So now we are going to see about the concept of physics. Initially, the physics is the important role in our day-to-day life. Already I am told, without physics we cannot live in the world also. Why we are telling like this means, the study of nature and natural phenomena is dealt within physics. What is that? Physics is going to be dealing with nature and natural phenomena. Everything is included in the concept of physics. So physics is the study of nature and natural phenomena is dealt it. So that's why I am telling, without physics we cannot live in the world. Then the physics is majorly classified into two categories. What are they? Look here. Physics is classified into two categories. They are known as classical physics as well as the modern physics. What is that? Classical physics as well as the modern physics. What is the meaning of classical physics? what are the things we are going to be studied in this condition? Suppose they will ask like this means, the classical physics are further classified into many types. See in the board, mechanics, thermodynamics, optics, electricity, acoustics, astrophysics, as well as the relativity. These are all the further classification from the classical physics. And next move to the modern physics. Modern physics means it contains quantum physics, atomic physics, nuclear physics, molecular physics, high energy physics, as well as the condensed matter physics. So these things are going to be discussed in the categories of physics. Suppose any of them choose physics as the major subject in your higher education, we are going to learn very deeply in physics. Suppose while considering one by one, I am already told classical physics is further classified mechanics. What is mechanics here? I am already told initially, also you know very well about mechanics. How it means, up to 10th standard level, we are learned about some basic concepts under the mechanics. What are they? Suppose let us consider your body. If the body is at rest or in motion, whatever it may be, it is able to travel from one place to another place. What will happen? Some of the terms used here, they are called as distance, displacement, velocity, acceleration, force, momentum, like that. What are these things? They will ask. That means the mechanics is further classified into statics and dynamics. What is that? Statics and dynamics. Simply we can call which are the bodies is at rest, we are going to be dealt under the concept of statics. Which are the bodies are going to be in motion, we have to discuss under the concept of dynamics. So we conclude that mechanics is further classified into statics as well as the dynamics. And dynamics is further classified kinematics and kinetics. What are they? Kinematics and kinetics. So under the kinematics and the kinetics only, we are going to be discuss very deeply in the plus one physics syllabus. And next is the thermodynamics and the kinetic theory. Thermo is the sense it is in the heating process. Dynamics is the sense it is going to be moving. So we have to apply the heat energy to the moving body. What will happen? So we have to discuss under the concept of thermodynamics and kinetic theory. So already we know that potential, kinetic. Potential means we have to interest. Kinetic means we have to moving. So which are the bodies are going to be move, we have to discuss about the kinetic theory. And next is the optics. Optics means initially they are classified into two categories. They are ray optics and the wave optics. Ray optics means you are very well known in the concept of ray optics. Why we are telling like this means, in 10th standard level you are learned very much the concept of reflection, refraction, total internal reflection, like that. These things are comes under the role of ray optics. And wave optics means we have to call interference, diffraction, polarization, like that. So what are these things means? These are all the higher education syllabus in the field of physics we have to discuss in future. And electricity and magnetism. So it's also you are well known, because up to 10th standard level you are studied about the Ohm's law, Joule's law like that. We have to study about the concept of the potential difference, electric current and the resistance and the conductance like that. We have to discuss in future. And magnetism. So magnet means you have to keep in mind each magnet having two poles. They are called as North Pole and the South Pole. From the North Pole, the magnetic field lines are passing to the South Pole. As well as the magnetic field lines are do not intersect with each other. Like that, we have to discuss in future. And acoustics. Acoustics is nothing but we have to keep in mind what are the things we are hearing now itself. They are comes under the role of acoustics. See, it's also known as the concept of the sound nature. As well as the astrophysics. Astrophysics is the modern development of the physics. Nowadays, we are learn about very much more about the astrophysics in the concept of the research industry as well as the relativity. While heard about the word relativity, we have to keep in mind Albert Einstein. It is a very famous equation. What is that? E equal to mc square. That is known as the Einstein mass energy equivalence. So that concept under the concept of relativity only. So the Albert Einstein gives us very famous theory of relativity. Like that, the classical physics are classified like this. And the modern physics. Modern physics means initially classified quantum physics, astro, nuclear, molecular, high energy as well as condensed matter. So what are the things discussed in the concept of the classical physics? Like that, modern physics also it possessed. In that modern physics, the first one is the quantum physics. Quantum, it is called as the photons of energy. I think this word is heard by you, but not in very deeply. So we have to call the quantum physics is nothing but the photons of energy, each photon having bundles of energy, packets of energy like that. We have to discuss in future. And atomic physics. So in this concept, we are going to discuss about the concept of the atom, structure of the atom. The electron, proton, neutrons are present. Like that, we are going to be discuss in the concept of atomic. And nuclear means about the nuclei only we have to deal. And molecular. So all the atoms are making in a groupism, they are called as the molecules. So each molecule contains more number of atoms. So about the atoms present in groupism, we have to discuss under the role of molecular physics as well as the high energy particle, which are the particle having very high energy while traveling from one place to another place. We have to discuss very deeply in the concept of high energy physics as well as the condensed matter physics. Matter means it contains all those things. So up to this, the physics are classified majorly the two categories only, classical and modern. Further classification means look in the board. We have to discuss in future classes very deeply as well as in your higher education about the physics. Next, we have to move the concept of the measurement. What is measurement? So wherever we'll go, we have to keep in mind the concept of the measurement. Why means? So everything it is to be in measured condition. Measured means suppose while going into the textile, while going in a grocery market, whatever it may be. So we have to keep in mind the measurement. How we able to define it? See here, the comparison of any physical quantity with its standard unit. The unit is the very much important about the measurement. Why means the initial is very important for us. Like this, each quantity having the unit. So the unit is equal to our initial also. So next is the, it is the basis of all scientific studies and experimentation. It is the basis of all scientific studies and experimentation. Whatever we do, we have to keep in mind, we have to give some of the units for the corresponding quantities. So here the question comes like this: what is mean by quantity? Here physics is a quantitative science, and physicists always deal with numbers, which are the measurement of physical quantities. So in that concept of the physics, which are the terms are pronounced by us, all the quantities are called as physical quantities only. So physical quantities is nothing but it can be measured in terms of laws of physics. From the laws of physics only we able to measure the concept of the measurement. So initially from the measurement, the physical quantities are further classification about the fundamental as well as the derived. First we have to keep in mind what is mean by physical quantity. So the meaning of this question means all the quantities are called as physical quantities, whatever it may be. It have a unit or not, whatever it may be. So all the quantities are called as physical quantities. So from the physical quantities, there are further classification about the two categories. So in the two categories, we have to see in our future classes. Thank you.